name is Mary McLaughlin, and I'm a technical program manager focused on engineering insights for a sports entertainment company. In layman terms, I just look at data to try and identify places where we can improve the way that we develop our software. So we can look at the data and see, for instance, that we're spending a lot of time with certain tasks on hold, so nobody's picking them up, nobody's progressing them. And then I can look at the data to try and understand why that might be. Have we not been able to get hold of the customer? Have we been unsure about what the customer actually asked for? Or have we maybe just misunderstood how big a piece of work was and that we actually need more people to build it? And then from there, we can work with the teams to try and identify how that happened and avoid it happening in future and try and come up with solutions that will help us get back on track. So from a day-to-day basis, I look at statistics and data coming out of the teams, and I provide insights so that the teams can adapt their ways of working. I'm also responsible for delivering projects that look at cultural engineering improvements, such as how we hire people and how we ensure that we have the right skill sets in future to be able to deal with future demand. So currently I'm looking at a program that is looking to hire engineers with less industry experience, so people coming out of university or college or who've been self-taught, and I'm working with hiring managers and HR and external companies to try and understand what would need to be in place for us to hire people in that position and what we would need to have in place for them when they start to make sure that they're set up to succeed. I currently work at home and I'm the only person in my organisation doing my specific job around engineering insights. However, I work with different areas of the engineering organisation every single day. I work with HR, hiring managers, external companies, and I report into senior engineering management who then help drive improvements in their individual areas based on the data that I provide. So to give you a bit of a summary about the technology that I use, I don't need much. I have a laptop and a couple of monitors, and I also have software called Business Intelligence Software, which takes all that data in and allows us to capture it and model it and visualise it in a way where we can then pass it on to the teams in a really easy to digest form. The thing I guess I would least expect about my role is, given that I work, I'm the only person doing this particular job and I work independently, is that a huge part of it is about communication, and it's a very sociable job. A lot of my communication might be via email or Zoom calls or writing proposal documentation, but being a good communicator is a huge part of it. If I was to give some advice to my younger self, I think I would just point out that it's possible to have a job that merges multiple, perhaps very different preferences. So at school, I really liked English and I was really good at computing, but I didn't really know that there was a job that could involve both those technical skills and the kind of more non-technical soft skills that come from being good at English, etc. But there are roles that use both of them, and just because you go into a technical role doesn't mean you can lose sight of those soft skills and vice versa. I think what's really cool about my job is seeing real tangible change based on the information I'm able to give teams. They can make the right decisions and they can use that information to target their time on the right things and be as productive as they possibly can be. My final thought about my job is just that I never really imagined that my career would go here. I've done a lot of different jobs in tech. I've been a business analyst, an engineer, product owner, a scrum master. But every single one of them has led me to this job where I think I can do the thing that I love the most, which is just help teams be as successful as they can be and help them get to where they want to be. Thanks very much. We'll be right back.